My first guest has appeared in films like Snake Eyes and Spy Kids. She wasn't in Snake Eyes and Spy Kids, but films like them. She was also in Chicago Hope. She plays a scientist trying to save humanity from invading aliens in the new CBS drama, Threshold. That's Threshold, that's it, isn't it? Yeah, and it's on tomorrow night at 9 o'clock. Take a look at this. Whoa! Please welcome Carla Gugino, everybody.
Good,
do
way.
I smell good?
Yeah, you
thank
do.
You very mm-hmm. much. You smell delightful.
Oh, why, thank you.
Well, you do. You smell piney fresh, but not in a toilet way.
I've been shooting all day till the moment I got here, so I don't know what that is. I mean, it's the Threshold set, I suppose.
Well, that Threshold thing looks fantastic.
It's really scary.
Really scary. How can you put that on TV? Folks won't get to sleep.
I know. I don't know. I mean, I keep being so surprised that we're getting to go as dark as we want to, and it's really scary and really complex and very cool.
And you work all the time doing this kind of thing, don't you? Because it's like shooting a movie, but it just never stops.
Totally. No, actually our camera operator said to me yesterday, he said, working on a TV show is like alcoholism, one day at a time.
Well, that's true.
So I think that's what you have to do.
That's certainly the way I handle it. Yeah. How is it working with the aliens? Do you have aliens on the show, or is it all just CGI?
In our show, the...
You don't have to pay any attention to that.
The people are... their DNA is shifted, and they have... been taken over in some way, so they might look like you, for example.
Oh, that sounds like a very inexpensive way to get aliens on your Yes, I'm an alien.
Exactly.
I've been genetically engineered.
But you know, they acted a little better than that.
Well, yes, I know.
No, it is actually.
Well, they'd
weird.
Have to, or they'd stand out. You'd go, well, he's an alien, look at the way he's acting.
Exactly. Yeah.
Although that could be one of the giveaway signs.
Yes.
Now, are you a sexy doctor in this?
Or
just sexy, plain sexy. That's it.
I do have a doctorate in it,
right.
Dr. Molly Caffrey. It's weird, though, because actually on the show, very strange things have been happening because there's an alien signal involved in the show. And,
like, you mean when you're...
When we're shooting, like just on set. Today, our director walked out and he had a bloody nose, which he has never had before.
Yes.
And one of the telltale signs when you have heard the signal is that your nose starts to bleed.
Or you're doing cocaine.
Well...
Yeah.
That is another possibility. I'm going to have to investigate that.
I'm just saying, you know, these are long hours, you know.
It's true.
Okay, we're ready to shoot. Let's go. Aliens are coming. Oh, I think one's here. No.
I don't think so, but you never know.
You know, it can happen.
It can happen. It is show business, after all.
Yes, I know. I've heard it happens in show business from time to time. Never to me, though. What was the... Have you ever had any alien encounters? You ever seen an alien?
No, I haven't. I mean, it would be a much better story if I had, but
I'm a resident alien. I have a green card.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And I'm really comfortable with you. So,
yes.
No, I haven't had the first-hand experience, but I'm telling you, I mean, weird things are happening, and... You know, I wouldn't be surprised if all of a sudden I have some strange extraterrestrial encounter now.
What would you do? What would you do if aliens arrived and said, well, we've got a fabulous planet, get in our spaceship and come back with us. Would you stay or go?
I would have to check it out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Even if they said fabulous planet like that?
Especially if they said fabulous planet.
Oh, we've got a fabulous planet. Like
that.
Yeah, all the sofas are over here and all that. No.
Yeah.
Have you always been interested in... I don't know. I might have when I was younger, you know. I think I did a couple of times when I was younger. But I think now I would stay. I like it here in California.
Yeah,
the climate's nice. Yeah, the weather's good. Are you from here? You're from here, aren't you?
Florida, originally.
Ooh.
And then I lived in Sarasota, Florida.
All right.
Then I lived in Northern California, and then I've been between here and New York for a bunch of years.
Oh, really? Oh, but
the
single clap. That was someone from Kansas, who's right in between New York and LA. Just, I'm right in the middle.
Exactly.
Yeah. So do you like it better? What's your preference? New York, LA?
New York is, you know, it's the best city in the world.
It is, yes.
But LA is the best city to live in. We've got the mountains. the water.
What do you do here? Are you an outdoorsy person? Do you go the surfing and wine picking?
I'm not a big surfer. I used to be a body surfer when I lived in La Jolla as a kid, and I got crunched by one too many waves, and now I'm like terrified of the surf. I have to get over it. It's like you have to get back on the horse. I have to, you know. Get back
you don't want to take a horse out surfing.
No. Although it could be fun. I hike.
You
it
hike
a lot. Yeah.
I like that. Do you go hiking up to the Hollywood sign?
Yeah.
I do that.
Yeah, it's a great hike.
Isn't that good? Yeah.
I actually went the other day with my little pup, though, who's she's 10. She's 10 pounds. She's small. Her name's
Oh, Luna. You're an actress with a small dog. I've never
but
met
no,
one.
No, no. Let me just tell you. I know it's a cliche, but she is a big dog in a small dog's body.
Oh.
I'm convinced. Yes. I'm not one of those actresses with a small dog.
Oh, okay. How can you tell she's a big dog in a small dog body?
She doesn't yap. She's just very cool about things. She's like, I mean, there is this thing that happens, which is like you do something and then it becomes, a trend. Like I got a tattoo when I was 17.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden everyone's getting tattoos and now I can't get anymore because now it's just like a trendy thing to do,
Well, it'll soon pass.
Then I can start.
Hey, if you're ever looking for an investment though, mm-hmm. tattoo removal parlors, they're going to become very popular in about
five
or 6 years, I think.
You say, thank God I only got
yeah,
one.
Yeah. But one's good.
Just
I don't
one.
Have any.
Yeah, no?
No.
Is it the Scottish thing? I don't know.
I don't know. Maybe it is. No, I've met Scotsmen with tattoos when I was in prison. Anyway, we're done. Carla, it's lovely to meet you. The threshold thing looks fantastic.
Thank you.
Carla Gugino, everybody. We'll be right back with Alice Cooper. Welcome back, my naughty donkeys. Oh. My first guest tonight, very talented actress. She stars on the Entourage show, Sundays on HBO. Take a look at this.
It's Edith Wharton's Glimpses of the Moon. The studio's been trying to tackle it for years. Nobody could get a handle on it. Steve Zalian did. The script is wonderful. Did you guys like Age of Innocence?
I don't remember the story, but I do remember after seeing it, I knew how to hold my fork.
I liked Age of Innocence. Scorsese doing this?
No, Sam Mendes is.
Oh, Sam Mendes. I love American Beauty.
Great. Read at least 90 then. And they need a quick answer.
Looks like we have homework tonight.
Oh, tonight? Come on, tonight we're celebrating somebody's birthday.
Hey, she remembered.
Nice. Where did you get me?
Hello. Carla Gugino, everybody.
Hello.
Hello, Carla.
How are you?
You look sensational. You must be going on to somewhere else after here.
Thank you so much. The premiere is actually tonight.
In the middle of the night?
Can you believe it?
Wow, because
I know.
It's like
crazy.
1 o'clock in the morning.
It's crazy.
Look, everyone's gone to sleep in L.A.
I'm just joking.
So with the premieres tonight?
No, it was last night.
Right. Well, that's nice. Hey, have you ever had a nice time on The Entourage? I love that show, The Entourage.
I know,
show,
it's amazing. Yeah. It was really one of the most fun television shows I've ever done in my life.
Yeah.
It was, I mean, the guys are so... There's something, I think, what makes that show so great is the fact that they are all so laid back.
Yeah, and they're all quite small as well.
they aren't a very tall group of
men.
Well,
that's good, I mean, because then...
a lot of spirit.
Yeah.
You know?
Hello. Hang on. Spirit, is that what you call it? I like, because they go around. And have they all got a little squeaky car they go around in, or is it?
No, but they're all, like, they love each other. They love what they're doing. And
it's
so
a
you
great
come
show.
On.
It's a really great
and,
show.
Yeah, and it's a bunch of great guys. They have.
Don't you miss CBS? You used to work at CBS.
I did, and
yeah.
I love CBS.
Yeah.
But, sometimes you have to move on.
Yeah, I know. We miss you here. Bob Barker's still here.
Yeah, I'm good.
Yeah.
And you are, which is really
the
best.
Yeah, me and Bob. Woohoo. Yeah.
No, but the entree, I mean, it was weird because when I was shooting a movie called Night of the Museum up in Vancouver.
Oh, yeah. That was great.
I meant to say it to you.
That was very, very funny.
Thank you so much.
And the dinosaur
totally
goes for a bone.
Oh, yeah, like a little dog.
Yeah, I know.
I had to go down and do one scene before I did. The rest of my stuff was like a month and a half later.
Right.
And it was at the Lakers game. And I didn't even know who my character was yet. I hadn't ever. I knew Jeremy Piven before, and I knew Kevin Dillon, but otherwise it was a bunch of new people. I'm watching Kobe make baskets, and I'm trying to remember lines. And right. I literally was like, I was like, if
there was an actual game going on, and you were filming.
An actual game. We were in the front
row. Was Jack Nicholson
there? Jack Nicholson was there.
I bet he saw you.
We were in Joel Silver seats. He is very charming.
Yeah, I bet. Yeah.
And, but I mean, the camera guys were there, and we kept having to. They every time a basket would be made, you know, we were in the scene, so we're supposed to be responding. But then when we had to do another take, as you know, we do. You do a second take, and you have to respond again, though they're not making a basket. So Kobe and the players are looking at us like
you're going. Woo!
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, and it was, you know, it's a bad.
That's what happens to me. Well, used to happen to me. I'm kind of better now, but used to happen to me at football games because I didn't know what was going on.
Right.
So I would just occasionally just stand up and go, yeah.
Yeah, that's generally me with most sports.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
That was a foul. How? What did I miss? You know. Yeah.
Listen, you know, you're Italian, right? Or, have you ever been back to the old country?
I go back as much as I possibly
can. Do you?
Can.
I love it there.
I
what part
it
do you go
so
to?
So much. You know, Positano is the place where I went last time, which was one of the most beautiful places.
Say that again.
Positano. Actually.
Hang on a second. Just let me have this moment. This is for Daddy.
It's the best country in the world. I mean,
yeah, it is. It's fantastic.
When I went as
apart
a kid,
from America, obviously.
Well, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
My last name is Gugino, so I think I can even say it's the best country.
Yeah, you can say that Positano again if you want.
My father. No, you know, when I went there as a kid and I said my name, they said, "What's your name?" And I said, "Carla." And I remember somebody said, "Carla? Carla?" And I was like, "No, Carla. It's Italian. Carla Gugino." And they went, "Oh, Carla. Carla Gugino." Yeah. And I was like, "This is where I should be living."
Yeah, yeah.
They can pronounce my name.
Have you ever made a movie over there? They have a very big film industry over there.
Can you help me out with that?
Yeah, I can hook you up.
Yeah, I appreciate that.
I once made a film with an Italian director and he said, you know, the difference between America and Italy is this, Greg. In America, you use movies to make money. In Italy, we use money to make movies.
Oh, see?
Isn't that nice?
That's the way it should be.
Yeah, I know.
Absolutely.
Then they pay you more.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, it's nice.
No, I had a funny experience when I was like 20 years old. I went to, I got flown over to Italy to screen test with this famous, you know, Franco Zeffirelli.
Oh, wow.
Amazing Italian director.
Yes.
And I was so excited and terrified. And I was invited to his house for dinner. We're sitting at the table and this older, wonderful Italian woman brings out a big bowl of pasta. And I look to the side of me and there's two little stools and bowls on the table. And I'm thinking, are there children coming? I don't know what's going on.
Literally, maybe the cast of Entourage.
Dogs.
What?
Dogs.
Dogs?
Two small dogs jump up on the stools and begin eating with us at the table.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Yeah, it was so Italian.
Knives and forks?
No forks, no knives, but very polite. No slurping or, you know.
Nah, I wouldn't
they were
fit
very
in
well
there,
trained
man. Yeah.
Dogs. Yeah.
I'm kind of slurping a bit now. We have to take a break. We'll be right back with Carla Gugino. Carla Gugino.
Taking your meds? It's all good.
Why, what's Lewis say?
I haven't spoken to Lewis. You're the only one who can talk about what's going on with you.
Well, in that case, I'm great.
There you go. Careful, it's hot.
I know.
Have you spoken to Mr. Tuttle yet?
No, I will.
When?
You were a model before.
Chris,
are you afraid? Go to a movie with me sometime?
I'd love to, but I don't think that's a good idea.
Come on, it's just a movie.
Maybe we should talk about the women in your life.
You mean besides you?
Yeah.
Welcome back. Welcome back, my lovers. I'm here with Carla Gugino. Her family are from Italy, aren't they?
Yes, they are.
Yeah, and what was that film there, then?
That's The Lookout, which Scott Frank, an amazing screenwriter, it's his first movie he directed, and it's so good, and I can say it because I have a very small role in that movie, a role that I love, but I got to watch the rest of the movie just like an audience member, and Joe
You know
Gordon
what you should
it.
Do if you have a small role in a movie, or even a big role in a movie? Don't read the rest of the movie, just read the bits you're in, and then it'll be a lovely surprise
that's
when you go to the premiere.
That's what Woody Allen has his actors do often.
Right. Well,
did you know
right.
that?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I worked with her on a movie, Miami Rhapsody, and she did not read any scenes but her own.
Right.
But
there was a lot going on with Woody Allen that Mia wasn't aware
of. There was a lot going on at that time, actually, as well.
Was it at that time?
Yes, it was that time. But but yeah, no, I'm too curious. Like, I'm the person who has to try to not look at the last page of the novel.
Right.
It's hard for me. I want to know the end before I get there.
Why? You should enjoy the journey.
I know, it's about
enjoy
the journey.
The
I know, I know.
I mean, you're Italian. That's what it's all about. Enjoy it now. No, listen, are you living in L.A. now or are you in New York?
I go between the two.
All right.
Which is super exciting. I just did Southern last summer.
Do you ever stop in Ozark?
Occasionally, when I just want something a little more lively.
It's nice. You think Ozark is nice? Yeah. It's in Arkansas.
Yes, yeah. I've heard.
It doesn't have an airport, but it's nice. So you live here, you like it here better?
No, I love both. I just did a play. I did Suddenly last summer in New York for 5 months, which was an amazing, which once I was there, I never wanted to leave. But now I'm back here and I love it.
Yeah. And where are your folks? Are they here or back there?
No, my dad is actually in Florida and my mom is in California.
Really?
Yeah.
Is your dad, does he live in a retirement community and wear his pants up really?
No, he doesn't. He's actually like the coolest sort of Italian, you know, Dr. Gugino.
Dr. Gugino, yes, oh yes. My Lord. Yeah.
He has better taste than me in clothes. He has more clothes than I do. You
really?
Know? Yeah, totally.
That's kind of awesome.
He's going to love that I said that,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, he has a lot of clothes.
Yeah, he has a lot of clothes. He has a lot of ties. He's got a lot of clothes.
Yeah, you know what? Whose tie is this?
Who is
Bob Barker's.
Is it really? Yeah?
I get to use it.
You get the recycled one.
Yeah, I get to use it. It smells a bit. It smells.
Let's see.
You know what that smell is?
Slight eau de vitamins, mildew.
Vitamins and wee-wee. That's the smell.
After I smelled it.
No, I don't know. I actually don't know what that smell is, which is a bit worrying. Listen, is it true you're going up for jury duty? Have you gone up? Did you do it, or are you going up for
no,
it? Or what?
Next week is jury duty. I'm terrified.
Why? You didn't commit a crime, did you?
No, but I'm afraid they're going to pick me. That's the thing. I'm afraid I have an honest face and I'd be a good juror.
Would you be? I mean, it's your civic duty. It is.
No, I'm actually. It'll be an interesting experience. I've never done it before. So no,
neither have I. That's the only thing about, you know, when I become a citizen, I'll have to do jury duty. But I'm just going to say, kill them all. That's how you get it.
Like,
kill them all!
And nice to meet you too.
Yeah. Kill them all! Well, this is for unpaid parking tickets. Kill them!
I think I'm going to use that.
Yeah, that's
yeah.
The, that's
hopefully they didn't watch the show, no. And then I can use that.
Yeah, no, cops watch this show.
Yeah.
Yeah. They like to know where I am. And it's the middle of the night. They can see what's going on.
Exactly.
In it.
Yeah.
It's like, listen, it's lovely to see you again. Come back and see us anytime.
Likewise.
All right. Carla Gugino, so everybody. We'll be right back with Randy Couture.
There's only one way for them to survive. Get rid of your clothing. It's going to get hot in there. It's going to get hot in that elevator. There's fire. And then some kind of pillow fight. I know how creepy I am. And I don't care. Please welcome the very beautiful Carla Gugino, everybody. Carla Gugino.
Why, thank you.
You do. You look like, I like the strap working across here.
Sort of,
like
yeah.
It's nice. And the shoes work.
I'm all matching. So
yeah, no, it's great.
I have two things to say. One is that we actually do take off our clothes in that scene.
This may be the greatest movie ever made.
It is the hottest day of the year, and we're trapped in an elevator. What else could you do?
Yeah, you know it's going to happen.
That's all I'm saying. So I want to say you're psychic.
No, well, I kind of saw it coming a little bit, but that's only because I've studied the form of screenplay.
Of course.
And you take your clothes off for this movie, then?
I tasteful lingerie, but yes.
That's okay, that'll work fine with me.
We do get slightly less clothed than that.
And that's Connie Britton.
And that's Connie Britton.
Yeah, I know her.
Who is a great friend of both of ours and who is amazing, hilarious in the movie and fantastic.
And both of you get into tasteful lingerie in the elevator?
We do. There are many ladies in the movie that is in fact part of
this. This is the big winter.
Really is.
Oh, you like the cup?
I do, and I've liked it from afar, but now that I see it closer, I really feel sort of special about it.
Yeah, it's some kind of Freudian compensation thing.
Yeah, it really is. The other thing is that in Sucker Punch, because I know that you just saw my friend Jenna Malone.
Yes.
This movie I'm filming up in Vancouver right now, I am Polish.
You play
I am
Polish?
A Polish character.
Oh, that would have been,
Dr.
if only
Rossi.
You could have been here in 2 days, we were having a countdown to Polish Independence Day.
I feel that my country is being honored and...
Yes, we've got a whole thing planned.
Well, I want to know what it's all going to be.
did you do a lot of studying for
well,
your Polish character?
Well, this is the thing, is that I hesitated to say that because I also don't know what we do for our Independence Day.
Right.
Though my character does, for sure.
Well, did you learn a Polish accent?
Of course.
Well, maybe we can all just...
begin by speaking in Polish accents?
We could learn from it. Poland. Poland is how they would say that they are from Poland.
I didn't know it was in Pakistan. Poland. They're talking like this in Poland?
No.
No, I'm kidding you.
But I like your Indian sort of...
Well, you know, hello, I'm from Poland. You know, sometimes people move from one country to another country.
It is true.
Yeah.
We are all mutts, you know.
Yeah. I mean, there could be an Indian gentleman example who moved to Poland, celebrated Polish Independence Day, and then got hot in an elevator with two chicks. I don't know, I'm making it up.
I mean...
I've never been to Poland, but I imagine certain areas of... the poorer parts of Warsaw may be much like this studio.
On Wednesday, I think you should just decorate it as such.
Yeah, maybe. We could probably do that. I think we could remove the giant photograph of Reno
replace it.
We'll replace it with a photograph of the shipyards of Gdansk. And right there, yeah. I think we go. Yeah, and I'll wear a big moustache like Lech Walesa. There you are. And Polish people across America will be delighted at my support.
Yes.
Yeah. Anyway, the movie looks very good.
It's nice
to see you again. We are out
so
of time,
good to
you know.
See you too. We are. Is that it? That's it?
Yeah, unless you want to come back for Polish Independence Day.
Well, I mean, you never know. I could just fly down from Vancouver, you know.
Are you going back up there tonight?
Tonight, yeah.
And of course, it's already 12:30 or something.
It's so late. It's in the middle of the night. I like to fly. You know?
Yeah, yeah. Well, that is actually the best time, you know.
It is.
It's the best time to fly. The air is kind of smoother. It's true. There's not turbulence coming up from
there.
Yeah, no, the air's smooth.
But I should say, in due diligence, this movie is really funny, really moving. Everybody is amazing in it. There are many a woman in lingerie, but also,
you had me at the two girls in the elevator. I think you're sold. Carla Gugino, everybody. We'll be right back. My first guest tonight is a very beautiful actress. She's in a new film called Electra Lux, which has got two X's in it, but I don't think it's a porn. Although I don't know. Who's to say? Me. Anyway, it's in theatres March the 11th. Take a look at this.
Life is fleeting, and if today is the day you want to be bad, why not be real bad?
And don't take this the wrong way. You're a very forward woman.
Forward and backward, too, if you catch my drift.
Why, just don't waste any time, do you?
I know what I like. And when I like it right away. So we can keep talking here and you can always wonder what if, or you can pull me inside and do to me everything you ever wanted to do with a woman in bed.
Can I buy you a drink?
Please welcome Carla Gugino, everybody. Carla Gugino.
I did bring you boiled sweets.
Yeah, I don't know.
It was really
not.
Unfortunate. That was my choice.
No. You mean hard candy?
Well, that's a whole nother thing.
Blonde hair. I'm glad to see you're you, though. I mean, it looked nice, but
Well, you know, you always look better with your natural color hair, sadly. But it's true. Most people.
Is that true?
I think so.
Well, then I better go to my natural color.
Exactly. I mean, like, bright red.
Natural color. Do you know what I thought when I saw Christian Bale get his Oscar?
With his
I thought
red beard.
Somebody's advertising what's down below. Don't you think? I was thinking...
Thought did not cross my mind, but you're absolutely right.
Yes, of course. You go, he's ginger down below me, boys.
True.
I think everybody thought that when he was getting it. I was like, we know
only
now.
You thought that.
No, me? You said you... No, did you?
No,
did you
I said I didn't think
oh,
that,
didn't
but
think
I
that.
Think you're right.
Can I buy you a drink?
But what's really funny is that Electrolux is a porn star.
Really?
My
the movie
character is
a porn
actually
movie,
a porn
then?
Star. It is not a porn movie.
Okay.
Sorry to disappoint. You don't see that much of her work. You see a little bit of her work.
All right.
But generally, you see
by
her.
By work,
as a...
do you mean?
I mean, you know,
is there lesbians?
There are some lesbians in the movie, so you.
Love
also...
it.
Yeah.
All right. You will love it.
Yeah, no, everybody, lesbians are very fashionable right now with, you know, Black Swan.
Yes, it's true. It's true. But but haven't they always been kind of?
It's with just me, different. You bet they have. Yeah. Yeah. Now, what happens then? Do you play in a porn star?
I play a porn star. She is pregnant, which is tricky as a porn star. Decides to quit, and she goes through all the things that women go through. It's like, can I be a good example? All of those things. Meanwhile, she is a porn star. Her name is Electrolux.
Yeah, but that's not a real name, right?
Well, she can't reveal those things. Do you know how to do your porn name?
No, I can't remember. How is it?
It's your first pet,
right?
And the first street you lived on.
Right, okay, so I would, well, what's yours?
Mine is Rubby, Rubby Crespo.
Yeah.
I'm not sure that's so sexy, but,
yeah, no, a little bit of Rubby Crespo.
But Rubby Crespo could have some fun.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
No, I think mine would be, Olga Daruch.
Oh my God!
You're like a Lithuanian shot putter.
I was gonna say you're like in a, you're like Bergman gone porn.
Yeah, yeah, you know? It's, yeah. Olga. Yeah, I had a guinea pig called Olga when I was a kid. Well, it wasn't really mine; it was my sister's. But you know, I got to hold it.
I feel like you have such a love for animals. Like, did you want to have a zoo? Like, I feel
I'd
like
love to have a zoo.
I'm
saying. Do you
want
to open a zoo together?
I mean, maybe we could.
That's a great idea.
Wouldn't that be awesome?
That's maybe the best idea anybody's ever had. So
I'm just saying, let's think about it.
Carla Craig's zoo. And that's put me first.
No, but I think
people would want that.
Craig and Carla. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe
what kind of animals would you have in your zoo then?
Snooky.
Well, perhaps one could be called Snooky.
Yeah. I think we should have a kangaroo called Snooky and another one called The Situation.
We need a giraffe.
A giraffe.
That could be called The Situation.
Although I have to say that I think giraffes sometimes can look a little bit, what's the word? Pleased with themselves, a little smug. Do you know what I mean?
Because yes, they are. Well, they're above everybody. They're looking down at everyone.
Yeah, and then it's like, you know, they can eat the salad from the top.
They're a little stuffy, those giraffes.
Do you think giraffes are stuffy?
Perhaps a little bit. Now, speaking of animals, I was born the year of the pig.
Oh,
and so I feel it's very appropriate
yes,
that today.
It is. Yeah. When's the year of the pig? Well, I'm not trying to work out how old you are.
Really, it must be revealed just
24?
Now.
24?
Exactly. Wow. And the picture of the pig that you showed is Danny DeVito, who, crazily enough, on March 11th also, I did this movie called Girl Walks Into a Bar. Two movies, same day, being released, crazy. Wait. And Danny DeVito is in Girl Walks Into a Bar.
No, wait. First of all, let me just stress that I didn't say Danny DeVito was a pig.
You showed him as that particular animal in that instance.
No, I said George Clooney's little cuddly friend. And then it was a picture of Danny DeVito. It was
you did say, let's see the picture of the sweet pig or something.
No, I didn't say pig. I was very careful because...
And now I'm bringing it up and we're reiterating
Yeah, you're really getting me out of it.
I'm really helping you here, yeah.
See, I didn't want to mention that.
Danny will find it hilarious.
Well, Danny will be fine with it. Yeah. What I'm worried about is that I'll genuinely upset George Clooney all over again, and I never wanted to do that. I genuinely regret telling that joke. Do you ever say it and you regret sometimes?
I mean, every day, though.
Well, yeah, but I do it on the show.
But see, that's the thing, is you do it on the air.
And then it looks like I'm somehow uncaring about the man's, you know, pig. I feel
that he's probably gotten over it.
You know, I do. Usually George Clooney's sitting in an apartment in West Hollywood going, ah, bitch!
Damn that Clooney!
No, he's probably not. You're right. He's probably going, I don't care about this. He doesn't know about this. He's in Italy.
Now he will.
Yeah, no,
he'll
he
know.
Won't.
You'll
no,
see
he
your apology.
No, he'll be all right.
But yes. Two movies, same day, which is crazy.
Well, does that mean you have to go on? Do you have to come back here tomorrow then?
I'm ready. We can talk more about our zoo.
Yeah, no, that'd be nice, actually. You know, I do. Why do you want to open a zoo?
I never did until I
just decided.
Well,
right
because
there?
You have so many animals, you have such love for animals, I thought you should open a zoo, but then you said, let's do it together.
Oh, well, I can do it my own if you want. I don't need you.
Oh, but you do.
I'd buy you a drink, but I don't need. No.
Speaking of drinks, Girl Walks Into a Bar is in L.A., one night, 10 bars in Los Angeles.
Is that a documentary? Did you actually do it?
Well, this is the thing. You shoot at the bars during the day. So you start at like 6 a.m. because the bars close. You know, they open at 6 p.m. so you need to be done shooting by then.
Right.
So about 1 p.m. you're like, I don't know, that martini's looking pretty good. Yeah. Like, I've been here for 6 hours. What am I doing in a bar if I'm not drinking? And I didn't, by the way.
Right.
I don't drink.
I don't judge
working.
You for that. You know,
no.
I mean,
but
I had a hopeless alcohol problem years and years ago.
I'm
1 o'clock in the afternoon. Like, home time. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So you never drank in the morning or compulsively?
No, no. Chocolate cake, now that's another thing.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's not the same thing. I mean, you won't have, you know, half a dozen chocolate cakes and then sleep with your friend.
Than, yeah.
You know, it's like...
a little chunky.
Yeah, you kind of go,
but happy.
Oh. Yeah. 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 Really? Are you big on the chocolate?
I am big on the chocolate.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you, like, when you start eating it, you can't stop?
No, no, I can stop. I just don't ever go a day without chocolate.
No, neither do I.
Yeah, no,
except with my teeth hurt. I haven't had any today.
I know. Why are your teeth hurt?
Well, I had them cleaned.
Yeah, you know, and they get into the gums with
well,
them.
Yeah, and when you have Scottish teeth... I mean, I've only got about 3 or 4 Scottish ones left, but they're still...
but they're You're still, becoming all American.
Oh, man.
You really are.
One tooth at a time, I tell you.
I like the disheveled look.
Yeah, it's
what happened before
Kmart,
you came out here?
Well, it, you know, I kept trying to look like a late night talk show host. Then I thought, well, look, nobody else is trying. Why the hell do I? So I make a vague nod in that direction.
I really like it.
Oh, well, mm-hmm. Thank you. Yeah, I like the way you look.
Thank you.
Let's get started on that zoo. All right, we got to go. Well, you'll have to come back for the other movie.
Yes.
Would you like an awkward pause or a mouth organ?
I think I'm going to have to go with a mouth organ because...
I
don't know how to turn that down.
No, you shouldn't turn it down. It's fresh. It hasn't been touched. Help
yourself. I'm sadly not as good as you at this, but let's see what we can do.
I'm not very good at this. I actually can't play because my teeth hurt. I have to just kind of breathe on the organ.
Okay, here goes. I'm following you.
Oh, really? Like then?
What do we do?
Suck and blow.
Well, that I can do. Here goes. I can't do
this
now.
Nice to see you. I haven't seen you in a while. It's nice to see you. Smoking, you look fantastic.
Thank you very much. I thought I should wear color for you. You know, just a little spice it up.
It's the, you know me, purple just sets me off.
I know. I feel that I should explain that clip because it sort of seemed as if he possibly had fathered those penguins or something.
It is called Mr. Popper's Penguins.
It was something
and then you see Jim Carrey with some penguins and you say, you look who's a new dad, and I'm like,
I had nothing to do with it. That's what I want you to know. I had nothing to do with the penguins.
Right. So.
In fact, the penguins are sent by his father, who was out in the Antarctic for his whole life, and finally the father sends these penguins to him.
What's wrong with a postcard?
I mean, you know, then you have no movie.
Well, that's true. Mr. Popper's Postcard
was
like 5 minutes. Yeah.
Oh,
that's fantastic. So the penguins are hijinks that would ensue, I would imagine.
Yeah, probably. For sure. I mean, I don't want to give anything away, but you know, it's.
No, no, it's Jim Carrey.
You can tell.
Penguins.
It's Angela Lansbury also.
Angela Lansbury's in
mm-hmm.
that.
How cool is that?
Wow, that's awesome. Do we have a picture of Angela Lansbury? There she is. Now, you know we do that here. You know
I heard
it.
Rumors.
Yeah, no, we do that.
She's amazing.
She, you know what I thought? I met her once, actually, Angela Lansbury. She's about 8 foot tall, isn't she? I mean, she's enormous, isn't she?
She is really tall. She's also really amazing. She is sharp as a tack. I mean, if we could be as sharp as she is, you know, right now, we'd be lucky. I mean, this woman is... I mean...
hell, Carla? I thought we were friends. You come out here wearing the purple dress, everything going on, I think, things are going well, things are going... And then suddenly, boom! If you were as sharp as Angela Lansbury, you might have a show. You're right, though. You're right. There's no arguing with it.
You have lots of very good qualities. She just happens to be particularly astute. I was blown away by her. And she's like 82 years old.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, that's pretty good. She looks good in her photograph as
she
well.
She really does. She really does. That haircut was different than the last time I saw her.
That was a short haircut. She was going through an experimental phase.
Yes, yes, yes. And don't we all, really?
Did you go... Oh! Did you go through an experimental phase, maybe at college when you were snowed in?
I didn't... I didn't go to college, in fact.
You
so,
didn't?
No.
Neither did I. I am also stupid.
Yes, yeah. There you have it. That's what I'm talking about.
Did you drop out of high school?
No. I was valedictorian, actually. It was a very strange...
Whoa.
Yeah,
that, well,
I know.
Then why didn't you go to college?
I was going to, and then, you know, acting.
took over.
I see.
That was what happened, and I ended up becoming a child actor. That's which is so strange.
Yeah, no, that's
plan.
Almost my story.
Yeah.
Apart from the valedictorian and the child actor, and the, I kind of dropped out.
Yeah.
I regret that. Do you ever regret not getting a college degree?
You know, I do mostly because, I don't know if I regret it, but I definitely thought it was going to be a totally different path. But because I love acting so much, it's hard to regret it.
Yeah, I know.
Can't
you get a degree in acting? You can get a degree in acting.
Yeah, absolutely.
What's it called?
I've got time to get degrees.
You could probably get one now because you're famous and awesome and everything. You could go and make a speech at a college and they'd be like, Dr. Gugino.
Yeah, you get like a fake degree.
Yeah, that's not a fake. You can get your own TV show and give people advice with that.
No.
Kind of.
Ooh la la! No, I'd have to do the real deal.
You're really?
Wouldn't you think, for you?
Yeah, all right. Well, what would you study then if you went back to college?
I wanted to study art history at the time, but now that seems like not as interesting to me as it did then.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, you've gone off art?
But no, I've not gone off art, but now I love to travel, I love to see art, but I don't know if I would actually want to sit and look at books and learn it that way, you know?
So what are we talking about then?
I mean, we could start, because we're thinking of starting our zoo also, maybe I would need to get some sort of a degree for that.
We were talking about starting a zoo. Well, listen, what about penguins right there?
Exactly. Okay, let me tell you about these penguins. So this is the thing. They had their own habitat on our set in Brooklyn where we were shooting.
Wait. These are not CGI penguins? They're real penguins?
No, they're real penguins.
I am their girlfriend. I want to see this.
There are some CGI penguins in there. I'm not going to joke. But we had our troop of penguins.
Right.
They could not function properly over 40 degrees, so our set the entire time was 39 degrees.
Really?
At which point I was like, it would be kind of awesome if you would say, like, Carla Gugino works best at 72 degrees.
No,
you... You know?
Can I just say, you work best below about 40 degrees? For I know my reasons, don't ask me.
There was a lot of that.
Yeah, I'll bet there was a lot of that. I know Jim Carrey. I know exactly what was going on. Oh, yeah, it's for the penguins, baby. Yeah,
but it was crazy. It was freezing on set the entire time, and I'm not good in the cold.
Really?
No, are you?
From?
I'm from Florida.
Oh,
that's
yeah, that would probably work against you. No penguins in Florida.
No, I'm very thin-blooded.
No, I'm from Scotland. It's quite cold.
I was going to say, you're a good, tough stock, right?
No. There are people like that there, but I'm...
But not your people?
No, not me. I'm more kind of like, it's cold.
Could you do that one more time?
Yeah, no, I do. I do that a lot.
Yeah.
That's why I was thrown out of Scotland. Can you stop doing that? Why?
I don't know. I think you could come up with your own dance move.
You mean for a horse?
That could be called something.
Yeah, no, I do dance a lot with the horse that comes out. I was going to bring him out, but we've done it already.
I don't know. I mean, I do love Secretariat.
All right, then.
I think it would be.
Who's that in the door?
For sure.
That horse works best at about 40 degrees.
Yes,
if you get
I could
above that, it's not going to work.
No.
Colin, we're out of time already. I can't believe
really?
It. Really? Yeah, really.
It goes so fast.
I know. Listen, mouth organ, awkward pause, or touch my glittery ball?
Well, I did do the mouth organ last time. I think, you know, the glistening, glittery ball seems appropriate.
I did not say glistening. I think you brought glistening to the party yourself.
I like to sort of fill in the blanks. I'll take the glittery ball.
All right, take the glittery ball. All right. Now, what happens is that we haven't really thought this through, other than I like saying, touch my glittery ball. But
right,
other than that,
what do we do with it?
Well, we're still kind of working. Don't just grab at it.
You're very protective of your glittery ball.
It's not that I'm protective. I just want you to work up to it, you know? You know, what I was doing originally was, like, you had to wait, and then I would say, Mr. Bus Driver, touch my glittery ball.
But I see.
It wasn't really working, so we need something else.
Well, I was going to do think fast, but now I can't because you won't let me do that.
All right, well, what about think...
Okay, do we make a wish on the glittery ball?
That's a great idea. What wish do you want to make? Make a wish on my glittery ball.
But I can't say the wish. wish out loud then?
Well, because it won't come true.
Yeah, right? Isn't that the
No, it won't, like, the wish won't come true if anybody hears it, but it's this show. Nobody's going to hear it, so...
Okay.
All right. Don't... You got to wish for something... You got to wish for something comedic and sexy.
Oh, no! Will you do my wish for me? I'll make it now, come true.
If I do your wish, it'll just get beeped out. All right, then. Let's just...
Can I hold it while you're making the wish,
yeah,
at least?
Go on, then.
Okay.
That's awesome.
It's pretty amazing.
Yeah.
Your glittery bomb's pretty awesome.
Yeah, yeah.
You can make the wish for us.
It's turned into an awkward pause, hasn't it? Carla Gugino, everybody.
I gotta see that movie. Carla Gugino, everybody. Look at you. You look absolutely spectacular. It's just
wow.
Sensational.
Thank
You're all
you
glittery
so
and shiny. I could just polish you up.
We need to do some polishing. It's very messy around here.
Oh, it's just kids having fun. We'll be fine. It's how I tell the future.
Yeah. Can you tell my future, please?
I can tell your future. Your movie about basketball playing
uh-huh,
nuns?
Uh-huh. Well, yes, yes.
It's going to be a big hit.
There you go.
That's good.
I mean, I loved you before, but now it's, you know, once we get...
That's all it takes?
It is. I'm easy.
Really? That's sensational news. What's the movie's about basketball playing nuns?
It is really. It's based on a true story, and it's a real woman in the early 70s, Kathy Rush, who took a small Catholic girls' college, Immaculata College. She went to, like, coach there, basically just to suppress their hormones was sort of the theory. And she took them all the way to the nationals, changed the face of women's basketball, and it's kind of amazing.
Let's go back to the hormone suppression. So they're going to try.
Generally, if you might be studying to be a nun, that might not be the way.
Oh, they were studying to be nuns.
Well, no, they weren't. They were in the presence of nuns. They were. Some might have wanted to be nuns.
Did you ever consider taking the habit yourself?
No. But I will say that in the movie, I did. We actually shot at Immaculata College, and the nuns and everybody there are so amazing that you can kind of see how something magical could have come from that place. Like, it is really, really special.
Do you know what? The first movie I ever saw had nuns in it. It was Sound of Music when I was three.
Singing.
Yeah, the singing. No, I was terrified of them, though. Well, I thought they were killer. I thought they were like giant killer penguins or something in it.
Yeah. This was the whole thing with this team, because I looked at all this archival footage, and what's amazing is these nuns were in the stands cheering. I mean, they were going crazy, and the other teams were like, there's no way we beat these guys. I mean, they have God on their side.
Right, yeah. Well,
do you know what I mean?
Yes. Well, it's a bigger debate, really, but I see where you're going.
Debate.
Yeah, yeah,
it is.
Yeah.
It's a much larger.
Are you an extremely religious person yourself?
I am not, actually, at all. I would say I'm a spiritual person, but not a religious person, which was actually what was really amazing about playing this role, is that I learned a lot more about sort of that whole world and that religion than I had known about it.
Have you ever been to Rome, the center of the Catholic Church? Well, the Vatican.
Yes.
I've been there.
Yes.
Did you like it?
I did like it.
Did you have pizza?
Sort of,
I had pizza.
I should have had pizza.
You did
have
pizza?
I remember looking at the Colosseum going, I'm such a tiny little speck of dust. Like, I had one of those complete, like, realization moments.
No, as specks of dust go, you're doing fine. You're, you're one of the more vavoom speck of dust. What you mean, though. I went to Rome.
You know, perspective.
Yes,
Well,
I'm from a very old country. Also,
you
I'm
are.
Getting quite old
you
myself.
So. And you do a very good British accent.
Thank you very much indeed. Have you ever been there? Sort of Britain, sort of like blinky
people? I have sort of, and then somehow you always want to do this. You know?
So,
I don't know why.
Like that. It was like,
none of my British friends do that, but everybody does it.
Well, yes. I was like, excuse me. Excuse me.
Exactly.
Excuse me, I have to go and get my sausages.
Oh, yeah. Just one moment, please.
I'll just get over here. I've got a... What was that?
And everything becomes like this. So
well, I used to be terribly angry at British English people, really, to be honest, when I was
because
young.
Because of their superiority?
Well, because I was Scotland, England.
Right.
It's kind of like, you know, them and us. And then as I got older, I found them rather charming. And they're always doing mad things. Like, I just have to go over here and get a hippopotamus I left later. We have to get it over here quickly or it's going to dry out.
But somehow, because of their accent, they sound really smart saying that, too. You're like, oh, yes,
oh, you don't want your hippopotamus to dry out. Quickly, get it over here. Yeah. Let's moisturize it.
Yes. Yeah. No, but I did dress as a nun in the movie.
Did you?
And
you,
it's so hot. Those habits are boiling.
You're telling me. I see what you mean. Yeah.
Yeah.
You're a Did you have one of the big giant hats?
No, they are. I don't know how they are not sweating.
They might be.
They might be.
Yeah, they might
know.
Be. Yeah, no. No, yes. So after Rome, where did you go? I'm trying to get you off religion.
I know, and I really appreciate
so,
that. I am Italian, so I like...
Really?
I like
with it. A name like Gugino?
Isn't that weird? Yeah. But the other side is Irish, and you may not know that. Burgess.
What is the other?
Burgess.
Burgess?
Yeah.
Is that Irish?
Yeah. Oh. English-Irish.
Oh.
That was a real conversation stopper.
I didn't know Burgess was Irish. I heard something about myself about Irish today, actually.
Really?
Yeah, I used to think that my mother's family were Scottish and my father's family were Irish.
Right.
But I heard from my Uncle James that, actually, no, my mother's family also Irish.
Really?
I'm a complete fraud. Yeah.
All this time.
Yeah, and the only thing that's Scottish about me is my enormous penis. Other than that...
There was going to be one thing that
was
Scottish.
Well, if you're going to take one thing from being Scottish, that's... And I was born there and raised there and, you know.
Yeah.
Do you fancy a commercial break?
Terrible. Badly.
Well, welcome back, everybody. I was here the whole time you were watching commercials. It was a good commercial break.
I was just staring at you the
whole
time.
Yeah, no, you know, I You must think men behave like idiots all the time, but it's only when you're there. The rest of the time, we're fine.
Really?
Yeah, we don't all bump into that. I have to go get my hippopotamus, you know, it's fine.
I really do want to meet your hippopotamus someday.
Is that...
No, that wasn't it. To double entendre. That was because you did such a good impression of the Brit.
Well, yeah.
And you made me believe.
Yeah. Because I'm being, you know, kind of fussy. Yeah. So where are you going
next? But did you notice that we're matching?
What, this?
As if we should go to an event together.
Well, we can go to an event together.
Mm-hmm. And we'd look very
regal.
What
event do you want to go to?
You know, we could go to the Wax Museum.
Sure.
Something, you know, go see.
That's an event.
I mean, I don't know.
Man, you really are. He's like, let's go to the Wax Museum and see Brad Pitt.
We could make... Those things freak you out? I don't know, I find them highly entertaining.
I love it when they get the photograph taken. Like, it's Paris Hilton and her wax image. Which one is different? Like, it's like, it's clearly that's not... I mean, I don't mean no disrespect if you're a wax artist, but they are rubbish.
It must be really hard, right?
Oh, it must be terribly hard, yeah. Especially when you get... It's
always, we can't judge that.
Someone super attractive as well. It's like Angelina Jolie and you get this kind of...
But
yeah, let's go to the Wax Museum.
But the more people get Botox and all that kind of stuff, it's just going to start looking more similar,
yes,
you know?
That is true.
So maybe that will help.
I'm going to get that done, though.
Are you?
Yeah.
Where do you want to get it?
Pretty much all of me. I'd like to, yeah. I've noticed as I get older, my skin's getting a little loose. So I'd like to kind of like...
Just firm it up.
Yeah, firm up everything. Just get like some kind of faucet at the top and just have it drip down my entire
body. It's a monthly drip.
Yeah. A month...
Oh, that's just...
No,
so,
that
that's
was a
not,
very
no.
bad one.
No.
Yeah.
Not good. That sounds terrible.
So the Wax Museum, then, that's a lovely...
I mean, we could have an
there?
Event there. I don't know. I'm sure they have events at the Wax Museum.
Yeah,
I never go. That's why I want to go.
Well, that's true. Do you ever go to the Ripley's, believe it or not, up in Hollywood?
I have never been there either.
But, you know, no.
I just
never
fantasize
have
about these places. I just don't go.
But the Ripley's, believe it or not, I think it's a very lazy title for a museum. Because they're like, believe it or don't
or
believe
no, whatever.
It.
Yeah, yeah,
like, what about Ripley's, we don't give it?
Uh-oh.
How about that?
Never thought of that, and it's true. What a
yeah,
weird...
It's like, believe it or don't believe it. Like,
whatever.
You just give us the money, sucker. Are you fascinated by that, though? Do you you know, look at photographs of people with odd things?
Not generally.
Oh, okay.
No,
I stole my collection.
No, but, you know, now in magazines, nobody looks like they look, you know? So it's like...
Do you know that thing when you look in the magazine, it says the stars, they're just like us?
Right.
They're not.
No.
I mean, they might be like you, but they're not like me. It's like, the stars, they're just like us. They pack their groceries. And I'm like, that's...
But everyone does have superstitions. Everyone has those little things that make them the same, which is where they're going with that theory. They just don't ever pick the right ones.
What little superstitions do you have, then?
Don't you have, like...
Sure, but I asked you first.
I don't know, when you're going through a yellow light, do you kiss the roof of your car?
No, I will now.
I mean, now you got to, because if you don't,
I don't go through a yellow light because I obey the highway code.
Right. Yeah. I mean, I gotta be a rebel.
I've got another one. Let's see. I have to wear a certain color of underpants when I do this show.
Really?
I used to have it. I only broke it yesterday.
Wow. How was the show yesterday?
It was pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I thought I was wrong.
Yeah, I had these rituals in theater, and one night I used to always put my script in one place, like when I'm doing a Broadway play, and one night I forgot it, and I was truly terrified, and I had like one of the best shows I've ever had.
Well, you know, that happened to me once. I was getting on a plane, and I always had this weird thing that I should never drop a coat hanger before I get on a plane, because then the plane will get into difficulty.
Right.
Yeah, I'm very crazy.
Oh,
person.
I do this too, though. This is, we got to help.
It's magical thinking.
This is, yes.
It's a symptom of... it's being crazy, but they but what I thought, and then I was getting on this plane once, and I was and I dropped, I don't even know why I was carrying a coat hanger, but I dropped the coat hanger and it landed and it scuttled off down the tarmac, and I thought, I'm in big trouble, and then here I am.
Yeah, you're here, and
I don't know what happened to the coat hanger. But that is magical.
I think it's
something to do with being a control freak,
for sure. It's a kid thing and wanting control, and then you start. It used to always be for me a color of rubber band.
Oh, really?
Gotten over it, but yeah.
Do you always wore a color? Because now you look like you're wearing a lot of gold.
These are my superstitions now.
Yeah. Mama needs some more superstitions. Honey, I'm feeling superstitious.
Jewels, please. Yeah, I think they'll
Tiffany
help.
Kind of Tiffany superstition.
Yes, no, I've become a little less superstitious, but you got to keep some. Like, you know, when I toast with anything, I have to look in someone's eyes. I don't like it when you don't make eye contact on a toast.
Really?
Yeah, it's not good.
How often do you toast? Are you a big drinker?
I'm not a big drinker. You can toast with tea or whatever, too.
That's unlucky.
Alcoholic.
No, it's unlucky to toast with tea.
Oh, no, really?
I just made it up.
Yeah. See? You can't tell me these things because I'll take it in.
Well, you know, I've got my big one is shoes on the table.
I trust you.
You mustn't do that because I would lie to you. You must know this. I would. To get what I want. No, I wouldn't. Of course I wouldn't.
Thank you. You're making me laugh so hard that at this point I'm actually crying, which is, I don't think that's a good sign.
That's good. That's like it's like when you drink yourself sober.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's like
you just come full circle.
Yeah, it's like, oh, yeah. I drank so much. Oh, I drank. When people say I drank myself sober, I'm like, no, you didn't, you idiot. You just drank yourself into a completely different dimension. That's what you did.
Yeah.
You ever drink yourself sober?
No, I never have.
Toasting people?
I never have.
No.
Yeah, no, I'm not a big drinker.
No, it's more.
Not my vice.
Pot, your thing?
No. If you'd like to know, chocolate.
Oh, boy.
That's boring, but it's true.
No, I love a bit of chocolate. Hey.
That's also, you know, it can send you into an altered state. Chocolate, good chocolate.
Yeah, but I've never had so much chocolate. I woke up in a jail in Tijuana with a sore ass and a tattoo. There's a difference. I mean, it's not like, chocolate.
I don't know. That sounds like it could have been a pretty unique experience. Maybe you didn't want to miss that one.
Yeah, well, I would have missed it because I would have been drunk.
Right.
Now, look, we're out of time. Quickly, let's, did we plug the movie? Yeah, it's probably awesome, right?
It is really amazing and super inspiring.
Awkward pause, mouth organ, big cash prize.
I will do awkward pause.
Oh, awkward pause. Right, good.
Because I did the mouth organ before, which is always fun, but... We've done that. We've gone down that road.
Have you started the awkward pause right now? Is this you starting it?
I can't ever pause in anything.
Oh, well, it's time to pause now. Take your time. Slow down. Let's add a subtext in here. One of us has passed gas. I'm going to add a sound effect later when you did that.
The lovely Carla Gugino, everybody. Carla Gugino.
It's like a mess on your stage.
Well, a little bit, yeah.
Yes.
It's a little bit. Hey, Carla.
Hello.
You look okay.
Oh, yeah. You look great. I mean, great.
Thanks.
Really good. I really like your dress.
I really appreciate it.
Do you mind if I just touch a part of it? Yeah, you can.
Look, right here. That's right, yours, okay. Right there.
It's very stretchy. Yeah.
Stretching.
It is stretchy. And it's stretched in some places, and in other areas, it's relaxing.
It's true. Well put.
Yeah, no, it's well put yourself. You look very, very well.
Now, and look, my shoes and your tie match.
That's a sign.
I think so. I'm not sure of what, but something.
Oh, you know what. I like your shoes. They're golden shoes.
They are. I mean,
did you win them from a fairy?
No, but I just felt like it was the last night in your studio, and I needed to do something special.
Well, I have to say, it's great that you're here, because you always light up the place with a, you know,
Thanks, I think.
So you always light up the place with your... Apparently, I have turned into Sling Blade for the last show in this.
You always light up the place with your...
Yeah, political animals was tough to say, too.
Well, it was. It was hard to say political animals. You may want to change the name of that show. I was in that show.
I know, that's what I was going to say.
Yeah.
I've always wanted to act together. I mean, we get to do this, which is amazing.
I'm not acting. I mean everything I say to you right now.
But
yeah, that's right.
But we were in the same show, but we didn't get to act together, which was disappointing to me.
Well,
though you were great in your part and everything, but
well, I played me on this show together. Talking about.
I know.
You know. Yeah, it's not.
I know.
Wasn't that big a stretch?
It was really good, though.
If you had to play a hot girl, oh no, that's going to really be hard for you. Now, who do you play in this show?
I play a journalist, a Washington journalist.
Well, right there, that's a stretch, because I've met Washington journalists, and they're hideous.
Well, you know, she's a smart cookie. She's definitely, her moral compass is a little questionable at the moment.
Well, that's Washington.
And that's easy for me to play, you know, so.
Really? Really, you have a dodgy moral compass?
No, I have
What is your kryptonite? What is the thing that throws your moral compass off?
That's
cheesy snacks.
Chocolate. Speaking of which, I brought you cookies. I brought you cookies that are upstairs waiting, fresh baked cookies for your last studio. Yeah, right. I'm Italian. I couldn't help it. I felt like
it's actual cookies we're talking about. It's not code or anything.
No.
No, it's not like I brought you cookies.
No, they're just plain old delicious cookies.
Well, that's great, because if there's something I really am looking forward to, it's more...
I don't know, we started going down the moral compass road. I just felt like
it made
me a little nervous.
Do you do a lot of baking?
Did
you bake these cookies?
I did not bake these cookies. I can bake a really good cookie, but I didn't bake these cookies.
Do you get baked a lot? Do you do a lot of marijuana?
You're just going straight for all the... No. I was raised in Northern California, so there was a period in my young life where I was more inclined that way. Not anymore. No.
Did you go to San Francisco a lot when you were there? That's northern-ish.
It is northern-ish, yeah. I lived in Big Sur. I lived in Paradise, California.
It's lovely up there, Big Sur.
It is,
you know, it looks
beautiful.
Like Scotland, but except...
It does.
It does, really does. It's like Scotland, except that people have all got big, shiny teeth.
Yeah. That's true. Yeah.
That's how you know the difference. Like, oh, I'm in Scotland. No, you're not.
Yeah, Kieran Hines and I were talking. Kieran Hines is amazing in political
animals. Kieran Hines, the Irish actor?
Yeah.
He's fantastic. Did you ever see him play Julius Caesar in the HBO thing?
No, Rome? I did not see Rome, but I've seen him on stage a couple times, and he is extraordinary.
He's crazy,
yeah,
this guy.
He is.
Yeah, I mean, he's like, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wouldn't have him out here.
Well, he plays the ex-president in this, and he was like, I have Irish teeth more than American teeth. And we were having a whole teeth discussion.
You do?
No, he does.
Oh, he does. Yes. I was going to say, your teeth are lovely.
No, I am part Irish, but my teeth are more...
Your teeth are Northern Californian.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Well, you know, it's a different type of character you would be asked to play.
Yes.
You know, if you had, you know, if your teeth weren't nice,
Craggly.
It'd be like, you know, they'd ask you to play Lady by the Guillotine or something like that.
I don't want to play
Lady by the Guillotine. No.
I mean, I want to, you know...
You want to wear the gold shoes and the green dress and go, And you should. You're beautiful.
I would get some craggly teeth for something, but not Lady by the Guillotine. Something more
interesting. I've got some. We used to do some sketches when I played Prince Charles. I got some teeth.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It makes you talk totally different, Tim.
Yes, I talk like that. All the time. Yes. I just suddenly started talking like this. Amazing.
Yeah. Well, there you are.
That's nice. What else have you been up to apart from the political animals then?
I was stuck in a hailstorm just last week in New York. Who knew that in 97 degree weather it hails?
Oh no, yeah, that's yeah, well,
I
it's the,
I
it's
it was
all
a
that
cold thing.
No, it's the Mayan apocalypse.
Oh well, yeah, the world is ending.
Yeah.
yes, that is why. Well, I don't think
that's true though.
Well, no, because also 2012 wasn't 2012 in their calendar.
Right.
That's
also, the Mayans themselves, the Mayan cultural heritage people have said, we didn't say this. Why are you saying
exactly.
we say this?
Because
and they're
people
like,
want
shut
something-
up, Mayans, we know better than you.
People want something to be afraid of, you know,
right,
makes
well,
life exciting.
Well, what are you afraid of then? Bananas?
No, I have no fear of bananas.
Any fruit or vegetables frighten you?
No. I'm pretty good with my fruits and vegetables. Yeah,
right.
They don't
what
scare
does
me
frighten
too
you
much.
Then? Spiders?
Spiders don't frighten me that much. Cockroaches. I don't like cockroaches. They move really fast, and they're very sort of like you don't know where. Yeah, I'm not a fan of cockroaches.
Jockeys are the same.
they do move really
fast. They move very fast. And you don't know what way they're going to go.
It's true. I never thought of that.
Yeah, jockey, you got to be careful.
Yeah, yeah.
If I'm in a room and there's a jockey and a cockroach in that room, I'm like, ah! So there, did you go on vacation this year yet?
I did go on vacation, as a matter of fact. I went to a very fancy place, St. Bart, where I'd never been.
Oh, yes, that's in the Caribbean. I've never been there.
Well, someone did warn me, though, nor had I, and they were like, it is going to be the scariest landing of your entire life. And I'm not afraid of flying at all. I've been flying since I was a kid, and I was like, oh, I'll be fine. Cut to the scariest landing of my entire
really?
Life. Literally, it's like we scaled the highway. I'm not kidding. Went straight up, and then you nosedive.
That's like I'm flying the plane.
And then you end at the water, and you're lucky if you don't go into the water. And I said, has anyone gone to the water? Oh, they were like, oh, yeah, of course. Many planes have gone into the water. So basically it
Why didn't you go somewhere else? Go
well,
to Vegas
I
or
mean,
something. The Vegas airport's huge.
I didn't know.
You can see from miles away.
I didn't know. I can't believe so many people go there, and no one had told me that before.
Well, did you have a nice time when you were there, though?
I did. It ended up being worth it. The first day, it was sort of shell-shock, like, this better be worth it. For what just, like, I just risk my life.
Yeah. Did you get a bra made out of coconut shell?
No.
What? You
Why
got
didn't
it?
I do that?
You should do
I
that. You're a sexy woman. This is the time in your life when you get
Where
to
I
do
should
it.
Get a bra made out of coconut
shell. Bra made out of coconut shell. Coconut shells and a piece of string and, you know,
and
enjoy
then you're
it. You use it while you got it, baby.
I'm going to think about that my next time.
Oh, I think about it all the time. When you walked out there, I was thinking, coconut shell bra. We have to take a break.
Oh, this is painful. I don't want to take a break. Must we?
Well, we don't have to. We keep talking, but CBS get all tweaked
all right,
out about
all
commercials
all right.
and stuff.
Okay.
Welcome back, everybody. I've never met this woman before in my life.
I just showed up.
Yep,
I
just
snuck
up in a coconut bra, no less. So, listen, you were saying you've all but moved to New York. Then.
Yeah.
You're there a lot of the time.
Yeah, which has really been kind of crazy. I thought, I have never, since I was 14, mm-hmm. I've always had a home in L.A., and I've always gone back and forth and traveled. But this is the first time I'm officially a New Yorker, so
Do you,
I'm like visiting L.A. to see you.
That's nice.
Mm-hmm.
Do you enjoy the smell of the pee-pee there?
There are a lot of smells there.
Wow.
You do have to get
it's
used to that.
It's a rich, aromatic feast,
it really
feast,
is.
Isn't
it really is.
I mean,
especially in the
summer.
Summer.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it gets
oh, yeah.
a little bit. Whoa!
Oh, yeah. No, it's definitely, you know.
Now, you
like,
know that all smell is particular, right?
What?
Well, all smell is particular, which means each smell that you smell, if
right.
you smell anything, for example, if you smelled something unpleasant,
right.
That means there are molecules of that, whatever substance is, are going in your nose. That's how it's detected.
That is disgusting.
Yeah.
That is information I so don't want to have.
Well, you know, you got it now. You
like,
can't unthink it.
You're right. Exactly.
Yeah.
So every time I smell some nasty smell, I'm going to think about
it's
what
going
you just
in,
told me.
It's going inside your nose. Yeah. And
it's not
and
right.
And forming its own little thing.
Oh, God.
Like, so when you smell like something.
I have
like,
a small nose. Maybe that's good. Maybe not much can get in.
Oh, enough.
True that. Well put.
Oh, true that. Yeah, yeah, true that. Word. You're absolutely right. Yeah. Is that what we're doing? True that? Yeah, okay. Fine. That's about all I got, though.
Me too, yeah. That's sort of, it's hard to go on from there.
Yeah, I like your, well, I guess we should call it bling. here.
The little bracelet?
Yeah, it's nice.
Yeah, I like it too.
It's like little balls on your wrist.
There's a first for everything.
Oh, sure. Oh, I love it when you're here. Yeah. And also, you know. Well, we're done.
Have we hit our peak?
Oh, no.
Hey, I just keep asking for it.
Yes, you do. Do you want an awkward pause or a mouth organ or a cash prize?
Oh, cash prize.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I haven't
Surprise
done that.
Surprise me. Who would have thought a beautiful actress would want a big cash prize? Time is it? Shut up, Steve!
For the big cash prize!
For a while.
No, I haven't done this for a while, so you have to remind me because I've done all the others.
All right, 50 Americans. It's easy. There's two ways to win. You can either answer a question or you can guess what's in my box. Here's how that works. I imagine a box in my head. I don't know what's in it. Only Jeff knows what's in it. So you try and guess what's in it, and then if you're right, Jeff will tell us, and if you're wrong, you have to take all your clothes off.
Thank Not God necessary. I have my coconut
bra. Yeah. Coconuts count as clothes.
Okay, I don't want to answer a question because I'll definitely not be able to.
Well, I think you'd do
this
pretty
This is
good.
When I get... this is what I'm afraid of. If I asked a question on the spot, maybe I should do it. Let me confront my fears. Okay. Here goes.
Are you ready?
Not really, but let's try it.
Iceland is in the North Atlantic. Its capital city is Reykjavik. In a recent survey, what percentage of men said they wouldn't mind being stupid if they could have the perfect body? Was it C, 19%?
I think it's C.
Is that correct?